Oh, hello.
Hello, John.
It's Nick Heyward.
Yeah.
Yes, I was expecting you.
Yeah.
I just forgot your name for a second. I was going to call you Nick Kershaw. But
he gets that a lot.
Does he? Right, well, you'll come in, Nick.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to play you a jingle.
Oh.
Which I've recorded to welcome you in. Just the first of several jingles that will feature throughout the show. I'm going to sing along. Oh. The nets have been washed, the sofa cushions plumped, the air freshener refill activated. With biscuits and tea, I trust you'll agree, your visit has been anticipated. Oh, welcome to John Shuttleworth's lounge music. Welcome to John Shuttleworth's lounge music. Hey.
Wow, that's magic.
Do you like that?
Yeah, it's nice.
Anyway, come through to the lounge, Nick.
Okay.
Take your pew, Nick.
Thank you.
Have you come far?
Quite far, yeah, from round near Oxford.
Oh, a bit snooty round there, isn't it?
It is. I haven't been there long, and I'm not keen.
No.
You know, I wasn't brought up in Oxford.
Well,
I was brought up in South London, which is a bit harder.
Yeah, you should move to Chesterfield then, because
yeah,
it's still the south, and you've got a crooked spire.
Okay,
but it's not very posh.
Okay, good. I like things that are not posh.
You've got good access to the Dronfield bypass.
Yeah.
Now, tea or coffee?
Tea for me.
Or hot chocolate?
I'll have a hot chocolate.
Will you?
Yeah.
Quite reckless, aren't you?
Marshmallows? Have
you got marshmallows? No, lad, we don't. You know, No, I'm sorry. I'm just going to disappear for a second to put the kettle on, Nick.
Yeah, okay.
You'll be all right for a second?
Maybe not.
Oof. Well, there's some chocolate Brazil nuts on the coffee table.
Ooh.
Blimey, he's high maintenance, isn't he? Between you and me, listeners, I was hoping to get Justin Heyward, you know, from the Moody Blues, but he wasn't available. But, no, you know, Nick seems very pleasant. And, of course, he's had a lot of hit records with Haircut 100 and as a solo artist. Oh, I'm struggling here because I'm having to do without the help of my wife, Mary, who's out spinning. I don't mean that she's pursuing a medieval craft with a funny bonnet on, you know. No, that would be lovely. No, she's at the leisure centre with a friend, Joan Chitty, and they're on their exercise bikes. Sometimes I've been outside in the car park and I've seen them appear in the window as they bob up on their haunches. Look like meerkats, you know. Right, let's take these through. Right, Nick, I'm back. Yeah, there you go, there's your chocolate.
Oh, thank you very much, John.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
Yep, cheers.
Mm.
We've obviously got lots of things to do. We've got music to play.
Mm.
And I see Nick has got his guitar out in readiness. Ooh.
And,
Nick,
I just
please.
Down, didn't it?
Well, you just crashed into Mary's magazine rack. And various copies of Take a Break have gone flying.
Sorry.
Don't worry, I'll sort it out later. Ooh. Right. Oh, excuse me, Nick, we've not come to you yet.
Sorry.
I've got to play the jingle.
Okay.
Show us what you can do. Bang that tabor, blow that kazoo. Strum that lute, toot that flute. You're a famous star, it's true. Show us what you can do. Nick Heyward. Show us what you can do.
Okay.
There's a great amount of strain about getting on the train every day and every night. The only thing that makes it good is seeing my favorite side. Prance a fighter's stride down that greeny escalator, yeah. When I'm getting off the train and my love is on my brain every day and every night. The only thing that makes it good is seeing my favorite side. crying in the night with the summer in her eyes tonight. Tonight. Fantastic day. But it's a fantastic day. I can find a funny feeling, funny as a smile, when your mouth is all dry. Why? Please tell me why. Fantastic day today, but it's a fantastic day, but it's a fantastic day today, but it's a fantastic. Myself again. Two lovers just passed me by. I tried to shave myself, be a happier guy. Why? Please tell me why. I can see it in your eyes now. Summer always smiles on a happy honey day. Am I being in the way when I'm so in love with you? I can't sit down and I lie in love all night. Night and day, yeah. Fantastic day today, but it's a fantastic day, but it's a fantastic day today, but it's a fantastic day.
Oh, marvellous. Thank you. Why are we called Haircut 100? I don't get that.
No, and that's what, that's the reaction we got, was why. And we like that. It was good. It just stuck, because don't know. It just seemed to work.
I noticed on the video that I watched on You Bend.
Yeah.
You have a lot of fun, don't you, in those early videos. And there was one lad banging bongos.
Yeah.
But there were voodoo masks in the background, and I'm not sure about that, Nick.
Yeah. No, I'm not sure about that either. I don't even know why it was a jungle. Why the jungle thing happened.
Love plus one, down to the lake I fear. Aye, 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 aye. Yeah, I love that.
I've ran out of lyrics at that bit.
Clearly, yeah. Right, well, we've enjoyed Fantastic Day by Nick Heyward. It's now the turn of somebody else to perform on John Shuttleworth's Lounge Music. Me, John Shuttleworth. Here's a jingle to introduce the item. Hey, sounds like Kojak or something.
Shaft.
It's my turn to shine. Not the sun or the moons or Martin Clunes. It's my turn to shine. So let the stage be mine. Oh, it's my turn to shine. It's my turn to shine.
Ah, oh, lovely.
Yeah. Right, Nick, are you ready for this?
Yeah.
I remember my first polo. Do you? The glint of silver paper, as my father said, here, take her. Sweet tea that will make you feel brand new. I remember my first polo. Do you? Trembling, I held the polo. Surprised to see a hole though, sensing what it was about to do. It gave my tongue activity, as the mince flavour's boring to me, turning my grey world as your blue. Sucking it was cathartic, I was suddenly in the Arctic, as through my young lungs a cold wind blew.
Oh, that's nice.
I remember my first polo. Do you, Nick?
Yeah, I do.
If you think I mean a car, though, you're very wide of the mark. Oh, there lies a gulf between our points of view. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I see why you're laughing. Golf, yeah. Just realise. Anyway. It gave my tongue activity as the mince flavours bore into me, turning my grey world as your blue. Soaking it was cathartic, I was suddenly in the Arctic. Thank goodness I was car sick. That's why my father introduced me to the polo, as opposed to the rolo, which would have been a bit sickly,
yeah,
wouldn't it?
Very.
Oh, I remember my first polo. Do you? Oh, hang on, listen to this. Oof.
Oh, it's like an aeroplane diving.
Is it? Well, oof, hey, look at that, Nick.
Is that?
It's my next-door neighbour and sole agent, Ken Worthington.
Oh.
Excuse me, he's come to the front door. I'll just get rid of him, Nick. Do-do-do. Oh, Ken.
Hello, John.
Hello.
Can I come in?
Yes.
Thank you.
For a moment. Why are you dressed like that, Ken?
It's a kaftan job.
You've got beads round your neck.
Yes.
I've got visitors, you know.
I know. It's your visitor I've come to see.
Oh.
Right, where is it? Nick, great to meet
Hello,
you.
Hello, Ken.
Yes, Ken Worthington. Now, you may be wondering why I'm dressed in this attire, Nick.
Mm. Yeah, I was wondering. I mean, I'm really into Earth, Wind, Fire, but...
Do you mind if I just sit on the floor?
Oh. Ken's sat cross-legged on the floor, like he's a mystic. a beatnik, you know. Is it the Maharishi? What's it all about, Ken?
Well, Nick, I heard you on Claire Balding a few weeks ago. No, it's months now, isn't it? And I was...
You were on Claire Balding?
Yeah, yeah.
You've met Claire Balding?
I have. Lovely lady. Really, really sweet.
Did you get her autograph?
I didn't. I've never asked for anybody's autograph.
Right. So I'd love to get her on the show. But she's not had any hit records.
John.
So it wouldn't fit, you know. I'd also like John Craven from Countryfile.
God, yeah.
But again, he's not had any chart success.
John! No.
But, sorry, Ken.
Nick, I heard you on Claire Balder. I thought you were very good.
Oh.
And I was particularly interested when you revealed that you'd had a spiritual awakening.
Ooh.
Because I'd like one. Can you tell me how to do it?
Yeah, silly Ken.
No, I mean, totally serious, John.
Well,
because you don't know this, Nick, but I've been through a lot in my life.
Yeah.
No, Rhiannon and my wife, she left me. And all she left was two wicker chairs.
Which attracted mildew, didn't they, Ken?
No, it was crayon, green crayon, that me nephew Nathan put on. But anyway, that's by the way, I've been in the doldrums for quite a few years. And yeah. I just need something.
Yeah.
Some experience, life-changing experience has occurred to you. I'd like to get a bit of it, you know, if that's possible.
Yeah.
So what happened?
Well...
If you don't mind me asking.
Okay, Ken. I was just going through a terrible time, like yourself. And it was awful. You know, my mum was told she was dying. I lost my relationship, my job... house, everything, marriage,
oof,
the whole thing, and it was a big moment, and I was feeling very, very pitiful, you know, and felt, you know, as if everything was piling up, and
yes.
I can't really explain what happened next, Ken, except for I was lying on the kitchen floor, and everything was so beyond more beautiful than I'd ever known in my life. And I just knew at that moment that I was like a watermelon.
Oh.
And
a watermelon?
Yeah. I was a watermelon, I was a cloud, I was a dolphin, I was a pair of glasses,
yes.
I was a room.
Excuse me,
I
Nick.
I was everything and everything. Oh. Was
brilliant, come in, it's time to call. Tony Christie. Tony Christie, the famous singer. Hello?
Hello?
Who's that?
What is it? Who's that?
Well, it's John Shuttleworth, and that's Tony Christie, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Yes, because your number came up.
Oh, did it?
Yes, I've taken the liberty of putting you in my phone, Tony.
Oh.
Perhaps I shouldn't have done that.
Oh, that's okay.
Well, Tony, we have to do a jingle, but I've left my cassette player in the lounge. Is it all right if I do it a cappella?
Yeah.
He goes, top tips on the telephone, direct from Hollywood to my home. The stars get on the dog and bone for top tips on the telephone. Do you like that?
It's great, yes.
Thank you, Tony. What I want to know from you is some top tips on coping with Eurovision failure. Because you did, didn't you, Tony?
I did, yes. I did.
Yeah?
Well, I was beaten by Kisses for Me.
Well, Tony, with respect, you didn't even get that far, did you?
No.
I've heard that you came third in the heats.
Yes, I came third, yes.
Right. Was that... were you gutted?
I disappointed, but in one way I knew that Kisses for Me was going to win the whole thing. So
yeah.
At least if I'd lost, at least led to a good song. You know.
Well, mean? That's right. You did.
Yeah.
You lost to a cracker.
Yeah.
I suppose the success of your other songs has made up for the disappointment.
Oh yeah. I mean, I'd had the hits, you know, in the early 70s, and then was offered this. I think was it 75, 76?
You're 76, Tony.
76, yeah.
Should be imprinted on your mind forever.
It should be, but I've sort of wiped it off because I didn't win, you see.
Yeah. Well, I think you've coped very well. I think Cliff didn't cope quite as well because, of course, he was pipped at the post in 68 with Congratulations.
That's right, and I think I should have won it, to be honest.
Well, it should. And, of course, we lost the contest by 1 point to Spain.
Mm-hmm.
And they won. Do you remember their hit that won?
No.
That beat Congratulations. It's called La La La.
Oh, that's clever.
It is, isn't it?
Isn't it?
Well, it is clever because, you know, everyone can sing it. You don't need to know the words.
Well, it's a bit like Amarillo, really. I mean,
hey, Tony.
Hey.
Come on.
Shalalala.
That's it. Well, yeah, you're right, actually. anyway, back to Cliff, because he was so upset that he tried again, didn't he, in 73.
Yeah, what was the song?
Power to all our friends.
Oh, that's it, yes.
Yeah,
power
and he came third.
Friends, yes.
He came third, Tony.
He came third.
Like you did, in the heats.
Yeah.
Right. What was it called, by the way?
Oh, Queen of the Mardi Gras.
Really? How does it go?
She was the queen of the Mardi Gras. That's all I know. I've forgotten all that.
Hey, that's catchy.
Yeah, it was a good song. We thought it was going to win until we heard Kisses for Me.
Kisses for Me, save all your kisses for me. Yeah, incredibly catchy.
Yeah.
Anyway, Tony, it's fantastic to talk to you. You didn't actually give any tips to people how to cope with the rejection.
With failure. It's to carry on, just carry on and hit the bottle.
Oof, Tony, I'm not sure we can include that tip.
No.
It's a delight to talk to you.
Well, great. You know, I didn't expect to be speaking to you.
Well, really? Well, you called me number. We'll catch up with you later.
All right, mate.
Well, we'll probably never speak again.
Oh.
Mind you, I've got your number in my mobile, so I'll call you tomorrow.
Oh.
Bye, Tony.
I don't...
Actually, I won't be able to call him tomorrow because I'm busy. I think I'm getting a key cut with Mary. She was the queen of the Mardi Gras.
Ooh. And then there was this, like, big wave of love.
Ooh.
Like, a love wave, you know. Mm. And the happiness that clarity brought is just still, it's just there today.
Yeah.
Even if
hello.
You're going through pulling your hair
I'm
out,
back.
It's just always there. Mm. Right, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, it is. God, what's that awful smell?
What?
Sorry, is that it's joysticks, isn't it?
Yeah.
Joysticks, John. Oh. I thought burning them would intensify the spiritual experience. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to extinguish this one.
No, John.
Yes, Ken, I must, because my wife Mary will be back soon from spinning class and she'll not tolerate it. In fact, Ken, I'd like you to go home, please, because you've been a nuisance. Oh. Well, I'm sorry, Nick, but, you know, we've got a radio show to do.
Yeah.
Right, so I'll see you later, Nick.
Yeah, well, lovely to meet you, Ken.
Oh, and you. Thanks for the words of wisdom. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Ken. Right, Nick, time for another jingle. Under the covers, we're not talking lovers cavorting. The thought brings a blush to my cheek. Under the covers is a chance to hear others sing my songs and me to sing theirs once a week.
That's nice.
You like that?
Yeah.
Right, well, it's your turn to perform again.
Hello?
Oh.
John?
Yep, all right, love. Oh, Mary's back. You've not met my wife, Mary, have
no,
you?
No, I haven't, no,
well,
no.
You're about to.
Ah, lovely.
Come in, we're in here, love.
All right.
Yeah.
Come on in, Joe.
It's Nick Heyward, love.
Hello, Mary.
Yep, hello. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Hey, that's not Justin Heyward. Well, if it is, his hair's gone a bit short.
I think Joan, this is Mary's friend Joan.
Ah.
Hello.
And I think she thought you were that lad off Movie
yeah,
Blues.
Yeah, I've had that. The last time I had that was at the co-op.
My mum.
So we're waiting for my mum's coffin.
Coffin?
Yeah.
Oh.
The woman said, you know, if you want to go through and have a look at your mum, Justin. And I thought, Oh, God, she thinks I'm Justin Heyward. I don't want to correct her. It's not the time or place. But my brother said, whatever you do, if you never listen to me ever again, don't go in there. And so I didn't.
Mm.
And so I never saw my mum's coffin.
Oh. Mary, shall we go out again?
So John can do some tidying up. His magazine's all about flour.
Yes.
And what's that funny smell, John? I'm waiting.
Nick, isn't it time for Under the Covers?
Okay.
Yep.
Oh.
Aye.
My wife Mary made a lovely shepherd's pie and peas.
That's you, Mary.
With carrots and gravy. Oh, and cabbage and additional greens. I said, that looks fantastic, love. And I tucked in hungrily. My daughter Karen did not. Something I wish I had seen. For soon my plate was empty. I said, Mary, is there any more? She said, no, love, but it's treacle spuns for rafters. I said, four. I had a couple of mouthfuls when I heard Karen declare, I can't eat any more of this shepherd's pie, Mum. Well, it filled me with despair. But I can't go back to savoury now. That shepherd's pie was stunning, but I'm halfway through my pudding. I can't go back to savoury now. My taste buds will go crazy, but I can't go back to savoury now.
Ooh, sounds like Ken. I thought he'd gone home. Ken, what are you doing lying on our kitchen floor?
I'm waiting for a spiritual awakening, John.
Oh, Ken.
I've been waiting a while.
Well, you will do.
Nothing's happening.
No, it's not going to, Ken. Now get up.
Do I look like a watermelon?
No.
Or a dolphin?
No. You look like you, Ken. And that's how we like you. Well, come and listen to Nick. He's singing me classic ballad. I can't go back to savoury now.
Oh, yes. All right.
Come on.
I can't go back, I won't go back. I'd love to go back, but I mustn't do that.
I can't go back, I won't go back. I'd love to go back, but I mustn't do that.
I can't go back to savoury now. A shepherd's pie was stunning, but I'm halfway through my pudding. I can't go back to savoury now. Oh no. taste buds will go crazy.
Yes, they will.
But I can't go back to savory now.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yes.
Mm.
Yes.
Yeah. So things are better than you, Joe. I'm only joking.
Yeah. That's very good. Fantastic, Nick. Thank you very much. We've come to the end of the show nearly. Just going to play out with a medley of Nick Heyward songs in my Under the Covers. Thanks for being on the show, Nick.
It's a pleasure, John. Lovely man. Yeah. Love you, lovely man.
Well, you might not think that once you hear what I do to your songs. Hello, hello, hope you're feeling fine.
John, it was off key.
Hello, hello, hope you're feeling fine. Nick,
sorry.
Please, join in a while.
Oh, okay.
Let me establish it. Whistle down the wind. That's better, John. Whistle down the wind.
Whistle softly.
Yeah, see, if you'd whistled on it, Roger Whittaker might have covered it.
Yeah.
Blue hat for a blue day is all we need. Oh, please, my love. Oh, it's wrong key.
Oh, it's a bit Burt Bacharach.
Please, my love. Do, do.
The things that I touch.
Yeah, I don't know the words of the play.
Please, my girl, really.
Is that how it goes?
The story of love.
And what about this one? Do, do, do.
Yeah.
Where did we go from here? Is it down to the lake, I fear?
Oof.
Aye, 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 aye.
Woo.
I said aye, 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 aye.
Dinner call.
Ring, ring, ring.
La, la, love plus one.
Ring, 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 ring.
Is that what you say? Ring.
Ring,
ring.
Love plus
ring.
One. Nick, can you read the credits, please?
Okay.
Bless you.
John Shuttleworth's lounge music was written and performed by Graham Fellows with special guest Nick Heyward, the producer...
Oh, hang on, Nick. And on the telephone, Tony Christie.
Ah, the producer was Dawn Ellis, and it was a Chic Ken production for BBC Radio 4.
Yeah, you never had a spiritual awakening. It doesn't work. I've just been lying down on the kitchen floor, but it didn't happen.
Oh.
It was a creepy crawly. Came scurrying across the floor.
Was it like a cockroach?
Yes, it was.
A cockroach.
That signifies great change then, apparently.
Oh.
If it was of any creature, because there was a woman called Byron Katie who had a cockroach scurry across...